Hey guys, it's me, Vanessa. I want to make a video for my week 107 post-op VSG surgery. Back in January of 2014, I was at my highest weight of 280 pounds. I had vertical sleeve gastrectomy March 13th of 2017 at 235.2, and I am currently sitting at 154.4 pounds, which is a gain of 2.4 for the week, a loss since surgery of 80.8, and a total loss of 125.6 since my highest. This week, I actually gained, and I knew I was gonna gain. It was something that I had planned out, not planned to gain, but I planned to eat whatever I wanted last week, and that's exactly what I did. When I wanted lasagna, I had lasagna. If I wanted to make like cheese and crackers with some turkey pepperoni as a lunch, that's what I had. I had lots of treats. I enjoyed some French goodies. So I did. I ate a lot. Now I am finding that my body, it likes to stay in this range. So I didn't quite hit 155, but I'm almost there. So it likes to stay between 150 and 155. My goal has always been to move it under 150. And so that has been, it's been a process. I'm getting better. It's gonna take me a while to get used to the habits and all that as far as my treat days, to find that balance. That's what I'm still working on. But I'm not over 155, and 160 is like my hell no weight. So I'm within that range that I need to hit. As far as like weight loss, that's my focus right now. I'm not over 155, so that's good, but I'm over 150, so I need to like move back in that direction. So that is the good thing about maintenance, is that you're always aware of your weight. I weigh in weekly. That is just something that I've always done, because it's easier for me to lose 5 pounds over losing 30 to 40 to even 60 pounds. And so, you know, regain is a natural thing. If you eat more than you're burning, you're gonna gain weight. There is no magic to it. There's no like, oh, I went off my diet one time and I gained 20 pounds. No, that doesn't happen. It's a progressive thing. So it's something that, you know, you just keep doing, and then that's how you gain. And so if you keep that in mind and tell yourself, okay, I will allow myself this range, and if I get above or to that high number, that's when I need to get back into weight loss. And it's not like a strict like, oh my gosh, I have to do this pouch reset, or I have to do really, really strict dieting. It isn't like that. You just eat healthier, and you eat the amounts that you need to lose weight. And so I'm back on my regular schedule, a regular eating plan, and I know with that I will be able to lose the weight that I need to lose. And so it's that simple. It's nothing to fear, because you are in control. There is no out of control. You know, you can control what you put in your mouth. You can control the activities that you do. You know, weight loss is all food, majority, pretty much all food, right? You have like this little amount of exercise, but you don't exercise to lose weight, because you can exercise and you cannot lose weight because of your eating can be crap. So eating is the most important thing as far as weight loss, maintenance, everything in general. And so like I always say, majority of the time, I eat the way I did to lose weight. I just have more freedom for treats and stuff. And that's exactly what I'm doing. I enjoyed my week, back on track, back to doing what I need to do. And then that's it. That's simple, very simple. I do wanna share that I am moving into phase two of 80-day obsession this week. This is what they call the building phase. So this is the phase that we introduce compound movements. So it's not just doing like a shoulder press, is doing a shoulder press with a bicep curl, or making certain ab movements with your legs, and so, or your arms. And so that's exactly what I'm doing this next 4 weeks. I am going to work on improving my diet. So like the last 4 weeks were not that great with diet. So this next month, I'm really gonna focus on what I'm eating and how I'm eating, and especially on the treat days, because I do wanna make progress, you know. I'm making progress muscle-wise, but my weight, not necessarily. So I'm kind of lacking in the diet, definitely doing well with the weights. So I need to find that balance. Like I always say, that balance. So doing well with that. I am going to start this week a half marathon training. So I will share on my page under Cessa Lopez, Facebook and Instagram, how everything is going with that. This summer, I plan to do a half marathon. So that is scary for me, but I know I can do it, especially if I train. But what I want to talk about today is self-love. I took a picture, last week. I think it was on Thursday or Friday that I took the picture, and I showed a picture of myself standing up straight, looking all curvy and beautiful and flat. And then right beside it, I posted a picture, and I will put this as a thumbnail for this video. And then I posted a picture on the side of me sitting down. Yeah, I had compression pants that were pushing the fat up, but I wanted to show the difference between what we see and what is reality. So, you know, we always see people posing, moving the right way so that they show the best of themselves. And we don't see enough of the real stuff, you know, like so many people, they put themselves down because they have rolls, or they have loose skin, or they're not as happy with their body as they would like to be. They have cellulite, they have, you know, wrinkles. You know, we always see beautiful pictures all around us, you know, magazines, Instagram, social media. You know, you see all the beautiful things. And sometimes we use that as our inspiration, that we feel like once we lose weight, this is what we're gonna look like. And it's not necessarily true, because they're showing the best part of them. They're not showing the natural, exactly what it looks like to sit down in a certain way that's not flattering. So I wanted to show that. I really wanted to show that, you know, even though there are pictures that I post that look great and beautiful, there's also things that I don't show. And that's kind of what I wanted to say, you know, and that we really need to focus not on the flaws, but we need to focus on the strengths, things that we love about ourselves, because pretty soon you're going to need that, you know, especially through if you're losing large amounts of weight. I've lost almost 130 now, because 125, right? I lost 125 pounds. My body is not going to look the same as someone who hasn't had any weight issues, right? I have loose skin. I still have, even though I had a tummy tuck, I still have loose skin around my stomach because I had so much skin that was stretched for so long that it had lost its shape. You know, it's the skin has been stretched out for so long. So it's going to be different than someone who has never had problems with weight and has never been overweight or even obese, right? And so we need to take that into account, that we need to be happy with ourselves now, because things aren't going to change when you lose weight. You know, you're not going to wake up a year later and after 100 and so pounds lost, you're not going to wake up and say, I'm perfect. My body is perfect. No, because you've done a lot to your body that made it look, or is making it look, the way it does. And so you need to forgive and move forward and love the things that you do enjoy, or your strengths, or that look good, right? So like for me, yes, I have loose skin under here, but I love my shoulders. I love the way they look. They're defined now. I love the way that my arms are really strong now, that I can hold myself up in a plank and that I can do ab work that I was never able to do before. I love the fact that I can run. You know, I've run a 10K. I'm training now for a half marathon. This is something that I would have never done at 280 pounds. So I'm looking at those as my strengths. Those are the things that I love about myself. I'm not nitpicking like my thighs. Yeah, I have loose skin on my thighs. No big deal. I have this loose skin. Yeah, if I can get it fixed, I'll get it fixed. You know, and then my eyes, you know, I have wrinkles under my eyes when I smile. So what? I'm 40 years old. I'm going to have wrinkles, right? And so we just really need to focus on things that we love, right? And our strengths. Because if we keep picking at things that are not perfect, you're going to, first of all, be depressed about the fact that, you know, you're not perfect. But no one's perfect, right? But you need to focus on things that keep you going, right? Like if I were to nitpick at, and I see this a lot in the weight loss community, people worry about loose skin. So they're willing to stay obese because they don't want to have the loose skin. That just boggles my mind. Like, why? Why would you want to die and not be happy and be uncomfortable for the rest of your life because you don't want loose skin? That makes no sense to me. I'd rather have all the loose skin in the world, and if I have to take care of it, I take care of it medically, but I'd rather have all the loose skin in the world and live my life for once. You know, it's being 150 pounds is so much better than being 280, even 240, right? So we just really have to look at our priorities and understand that, like I said, we're not perfect. We have flaws. All of us have flaws. Even the perfect people you see out there, they all have flaws. They just don't show it. And so it's just so important to keep that in mind. So I just wanted to share that message. And I will make an attempt to show more of the flaws, because that needs to be out there. That really needs to be out there, because we only see a small part of our lives, you know, on social media. We show the good. That is the goal, is to always show the good, because we feel like we want to motivate and inspire people. And then we forget that sometimes showing some of the heartache and the bad and the complicated is also important, because it shows people that they're not alone, that, you know, their feelings are just like someone else who is struggling with the same thing, you know? So it's so important to show the whole aspect, you know? And like I always say, it's being transparent. I try to be very transparent. So I just wanted to share that. And you guys have an amazing week. You will be seeing a video, not next week, but the week after. So if you don't see one next week, that's why. But I'm still gonna weigh in, because we're going on vacation. But yeah, you guys take care. I will see you all very, very soon. Follow me on social media if you wanna see me daily. Check in with my accountability, fitness, and health. And I can be found under Facebook and Instagram under Cessa Lopez. Guys, take care. Bye for now.